Hi, I'm Sherman Rowland, and we're going to talk about some troubleshooting for your Lortone LS10, and also it applies to the Highland Park HT10. And I've simulated this a little bit because this is a common question people ask me. If you look at the carriage here, I took the vise off, the vise bolt's right on the top of here, and you'll notice that this thing, it's kind of loose, rocking back and forth. Now, this is not going to give me a good cut when that carriage is rocking like that. Now, underneath, you can see there's a bolt right back here. It's a little bolt that goes in that side, and inside there, there's a nut underneath. There's a bolt. Trust me, you can't see it, but look at your saw, you'll see it. On the other side, you'll see a bolt on this side. You can see the bolt right underneath there. My fingertip, there's a bolt. So, now, when I go to adjust those two bolts, they kind of hold against the rail, so it stabilizes and centers the carriage. What I want to do is I want to set those up so the vise itself, the vise base, is parallel to the height of this. So I'm going to take my speed square here, I'm just putting, and I can look in and say, yeah, that's pretty consistent. So it's that inside bolt that I need to tighten, because you can see my movement is this way. And you'll also notice, you'll really see that when I engage the feed nut, it flips up because the carriage is slumping relative to where it should be for that, where that feed nut is. So I'm going to grab two wrenches here, 2 7/16-inch wrenches, and I'm going to reach behind here. I'm going to get a wrench up underneath here. I'm going to loosen that inside nut, and what I want to do is loosen that jam nut, and lo and behold, that jam nut. I'm going to tighten that up because it was loose. And what I'm doing is I'm seeing, okay, I've basically taken all the slop out of this, but I gotta make sure it still slides okay. A little bit more that I need to take out. I'm gonna tighten that bolt until it contacts. And these bolts in here are not a normal bolt. This is brass. It's basically a brass bolt. And the brass bolt has really good wear characteristics. Now, if I try that, that's too tight. I cannot move the carriage. So I'm gonna back that bolt off just a hair. And then I'm gonna take that nut behind there, get that ready to tighten. And sometimes when you tighten the nut, it's going to move the bolt. In my case, it didn't, but you'll notice now I don't have any of that flip-flop and side motion right here. So I've snugged up the travel so this is not flopping anymore. And you see when I engage the feed nut, the carriage is not moving to the side. Now also I can feel, you feel that little click, 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 click front to back. What you can see underneath here is in that jam nut, I'll show you here, in that lock collar there, there's a little bit of space. So what I need to do is I need to actually bring that lock collar in a little bit. So I am going to momentarily turn on the saw so I can move the feed nut to the top. I mean that lock collar to the top. Loosen it. Make sure I'm on the flat. And I tighten it back up. And that's going to eliminate that front to back motion. A little bit in there. Move that a little bit more here. There we go. I got it. I felt it. Move. Now, no more front to back, no more side to side. That's going to make a marked difference in your performance of your cutting. These are simple things to do. If you expose these basic secrets of how these machines work, nothing really that fancy about them. So the first thing I did is I noticed that I had the rocking, so I wanted to make sure that this is level. And the reason why I care about level is I can assume, since my arbor shaft is bolted onto this plate here, it's actually a plate underneath there, but on the Lortone's bolted here, that those bearings are going to sit level and level to this plate, and so I want to actually have my vise base being pretty level to that. I'm not going to worry if it's in within a, you know, thousands of an inch, but I'm looking at being pretty darn level there. So what I've done is I've solved two problems, that rocking sound and also the front to back. Now the next thing I want to do in this saw is going to be put on the really cool retrofit. Now, if you like more videos like this, go check out our website. You go to www.hplapidary.com, just all one word, hplapidary, L-A-P-I-D-A-R-Y.com, and go up to the top of the website and you'll see called Video Library. And in there, you're going to find hundreds of videos covering all kinds of topics about how to fix your saw and save yourself money. I frankly would rather happier you get yourself your saw fixed, and then you can buy some beautiful agate, because it's really about cutting the rock. It's not about the machines. Hey, thanks for watching today. If you like what you see, click the like button. Subscribe if you want to get more videos like this. And down below in the description, you'll find a link that goes to our website. It goes to also what we showed you today, more information about that. And leave comments. If there's things that you like, there's things that you want us to do more on, if there's videos that you want us to shoot that we haven't shot, we're very open to that. We're really looking for ways to help you be successful in your endeavors with the tools and technologies that we create, as well as any other aspect of the hobby.